fresh 1.3 is out. Yep, we got a new release.
Another one.
You better get used to it, because we are planning to release new minor versions for Fresh on a monthly basis from now on. We promised in the last video that we are betting on Fresh, and we are sticking to that promise. This development cycle contained a lot of incredible PRs from the community, and we are thrilled to see all the excitement around Fresh. The documentation has been expanded and improved, many bugs were fixed, and new features were added. Here are the main takeaways from this release. In past versions, passing data from a router handler to the page's component required a bit of annoying boilerplate. To ensure type safety, you had to create an interface for the component's props, pass that to the handler's type as a generic, and then use that in the component definition. The getHandler is very often highly coupled to the component it will render, so we ended up merging the two together. As a result, starting with Fresh 1.3, the previous code can be refactored to something like this. Don't worry, there is no need to rewrite all your routes. The new approach is an additional option that can make simple routes a bit easier to write. It is not a requirement to use async routes, and there will still be a lot of scenarios where you'll need a handler anyway. However, this goes to show that here at Deno, we are committed to remove boilerplate and simplify the coding experience whenever possible. In this new version, we are also improving our error handling support. When something fails in a route handler, Fresh will now automatically render the 500.tsx file template as a fallback. And, in rarer situations, when errors are thrown during rendering, we added support for error boundaries. When preact detects components that have a component didCatch method or a static getDerived state from error method, those components become error boundaries and can catch errors and render a fallback UI. Don't worry, we know that the dev experience feels a bit raw at the moment, and we are already considering different ways to make this API feel more integrated with Fresh itself. And since we are talking dev experience, we got new linting rules, better error messaging in the configuration process, and various quality of life improvements such as being able to access route parameters from every handler, and a better starter template to help you start the project in no time. In version 1.2, we made sure you can structure your islands in folder and subfolders. In this new version, we are adding even more flexibility to islands, and you can now export as many islands in a file as you want. Grouping islands in a single file reduces the number of requests a site has to make, and can even make some sites a little bit faster. Finally, Fresh builds on top of the Deno 1.35 release, and will use Deno Serve when possible. This new API is not just faster, but also simpler than the previous alternative. As always, you can find a detailed overview of the latest Fresh version in the video description. Please click the subscribe button if you want to stay up to date with everything Deno related, and see you in the next one!